Hello everyone, welcome to day 6 of the holiday card series for 2020. So happy to see so many of you in the chat. Thank you for joining me today. This is a really special day because it is the day that Simas's Stamps holiday release, which they've called Holly Jolly, went live at midnight Eastern last night. And there are some amazing products, some that I've designed, and we're going to be using one of those today. It's actually a collaboration set with a new friend of mine. Her name is Lydia Diaz, and she is Clever Girl Craftings on Instagram. She also has an amazing Etsy shop, and she has these awesome illustrations that I saw on Instagram, and I messaged her out of the blue. We didn't know each other beforehand, and I was like, hey girl, have you considered making stamps? Because I kind of want to color in your images. And she hadn't really thought about it. And I was so excited that I brought Heidi from Simas's Stamp on board, and we collaborated with Lydia to bring you 2 stamp sets, which are amazing. So I'm going to show you those right now, and then we'll get to all of the crafting. Okay, so these are the 2 stamp sets. And there's a really fun story with this one as well. But this is the large stamp set. It's a 6x8. And it is called Rest Queen. Look at these cute images at the bottom. I think this girl was the first one I saw on her Instagram, because she's sold these images as stickers in her shop for a while. And so cute. Love it. So I'm really looking forward to coloring that one, although that's not the one I'm coloring today. Anyway, so many cute little images. These are her illustrations, and then I paired it with my lettering and typography. So it was a collaboration, but really it's mostly her, because these images are so cute. And on the back, there's a cute picture of Lydia. It says some little things about her and stuff. By the way, she has chosen an organization to donate the proceeds or the profits from the stamp set to, and Heidi at Simon was eager to help out as well. She is donating the profits to Therapy for Black Girls. I think that's the name of it. They're on Instagram. They're a great organization. So it's amazing. So both of these stamp sets, the profits from that. And then this one, obviously my lettering, right? Says, I accept people the way they are because that's what Jesus did for me. And she said this while we were on our first initial Zoom call with Heidi. Lydia said this exact phrase, and Heidi said, stop, write that down. That needs to be a stamp. So that's the story behind this extra stamp on the side. Hope you guys check it out. So let's get into the crafting. I'm so happy to see all of you coming in. Hello, so many people. Wisconsin, West Virginia, New Jersey, Massachusetts, Sweden, Florida, India, Taiwan. Wow, Taiwan, Ohio, Germany, New Zealand, East Texas, Wales, Ontario, Canada. Amazing. Denver. Oh, you're just like, hey, over to the east. Hey, Denver. Oh, Lara was reminding me in the chat to wet my stamp chamois. I always forget to do that. Thankfully, I won't need it today. I've done lots of prep work. But just in case, I do have water on by, standing on by. Okay, so let's get to the crafting. So like I said before, this is the stamp set I'm going to be using today. And I'm going to turn it into a Christmas card. I thought it'd be kind of fun. So what I've done is I've stamped 3 of the images, the little girl, the pillow, and the blanket. And I've stamped that in antique linen distress ink. Ta-da! It's this distress ink over here. It's my favorite ink for doing no-line watercoloring. So that's what I'm going to do today, some no-line watercoloring. I'll put the stamp set off to the side. Just a reminder, it's called Rest Queen. It's listed down below in the supplies in the video description. I plugged that in last night as soon as the stamp set was live, so you can click over there if you want. Okay. Oh my word, even more saying where they're from. San Diego, South Africa. Amazing. Michigan, Missoula, Montana. Hello, neighbor. You're far away geographically, but out in the West, far away is, it has a different meaning than back East. It's interesting. Okay, so we're going to get to the painting. Let me grab this. I have my big tray of distress inks on standby because that's what I'm going to be using today for my watercoloring. I like to use distress ink with no line watercoloring. I don't know. I think it's because it was the first thing I used when I started no line watercoloring. So here we are. So this is where I'm going to be pulling colors from. I'm going to be smushing the colors onto a palette. So I've got like a clear palette. Let me see. There we go. You can see it's slick. So I'll be smushing them onto that, doing some painting. Okay. Alrighty. Hello in the chat. So to the side here. Alright, I think I want to give her some really gorgeous brown skin. So I'm going to see if I can mix some colors here to get this going to a color that I really love. Okay. Oh, sorry. It's behind my little circle head. You know what? Maybe I will turn me off up in the corner so you can see the full palette. Okay, there we go. Oh, even more people saying where they're from. Billings, Montana, Guadalajara, Mexico, Southern California, Winnipeg, Manitoba. Hey, Dana. Dana's joining us. We've got two people from Kentucky who just chimed in at the same time. That's fun. Belgium. Awesome. Okay, I think I'm going to have... All right, because I'm going to have her cheek color and then her skin color. And we'll get to her hair in a little bit. Okay. I'm using a size 2 silver black velvet brush. In fact, I'm going to zoom in even more for you guys. I'll show you smushing and picking up color, but then we'll make the painting the main part. All right, I've got Vintage Photo. I'm anticipating I might need some Ground Espresso. It's just a little bit of a deeper brown. And I'm going to do Festive Berries on her cheeks. I'll have to water that down a little bit. Okay. I also like to have a paper towel on hand just to dab off my brush as I need to. And here we go. All right, so when I pick these up, I'm just putting my wet brush into it right there. And I don't want to start too dark because I can't lighten it up very much. So I'm going to start, let's see, we're just going to come right in here. And I have a little hair in my brush. I think that helped. Okay. So I like to bring in the darkest shade at the edge. Then I'll swish my brush, dab it off, and then I can kind of spread that color out. And I stamped this image last night, so I don't think the lines are really gonna disappear as much as they normally would, so the lines will probably still be a little bit visible, but that's okay. Just want a nice color. Okay. All right. I'm gonna come down and get her arms. I think only the top of her arms will actually be showing. I'm planning to have the blanket over top of her. So I'm not going to spend all the time painting everything down below because the blanket will cover it. But I do need to get the top of her arms because I want the heart on her pajamas to show. So I need at least get it down to right there, you know? So cute. Hey, Lisa. My friend Lisa, Terry Lisa, has been busy, busy, busy. She's been busy all day. She's even listening with it on mute because she's in a meeting. Some of this color is bleeding up into the face, but that's okay because that part will be a little darker anyway. All right, and while that's still a little bit damp, I'm gonna come in with some festive berries, kind of a little watered down. I'm just gonna start putting a little color on her cheeks. So cute. And it is bleeding out quite a bit. Totally okay, that's what I anticipated. I'm using just a damp brush to sort of spread that out. So cute. Okay. Lisa's, don't give her a beard. I'm not giving her a beard. That's her neck. Too funny. All right. I'm going to hit this with my heat tool just to stop the color spreading and dry it. Okay, by the way, this paper is Fabriano Artistico, extra white. All right, I'm gonna need to walk back some of that pink, get that kind of spreading so it's not such a harsh line. I think that'll do. Okay. All right, and I just added water to her face, but I wanna do shading on her eyelid, so dry again. Not need that ground espresso because the vintage photo at full strength is actually working out really well. We can zoom in even more. Okay. All right, so here's her eyelid. Getting my brush wet. And I'm going to just come in here. And just give it a little bit of dimension. Have to laugh at some of these comments. The trolls have found us, y'all. Okay. Stand by. I have to go over to the chat and block people. All right. He will be gone. Also, Dana Joy, if you're going to be here, I just made you a little moderator. So if you can throw out people, that'd be great. Okay. Oh, I love her eyelids like that. I think it looks so cute. And I'm gonna add some of that really strong shading around the edge of her face now, so it'll stand out. She's gonna be real cute. Oh, sorry if I'm going out of focus. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit so it'll have more of an opportunity to focus. Getting this hairline. Oh, she's gonna be cute. All right. All right, Dana, I made you your moderator. Counting on you to keep the playground nice. I know Dana, she doesn't take silliness from anyone. All right. Hello, everyone who's joining live for the first time. Okay, you know, with all this shading, I feel like she needs a little bit of definition on her nose. So I think what I'm gonna do, I do this every once in a while, I just like to add like a little bit of a shadow that leads up to the eyebrow. And I don't necessarily have to do it on both sides, but it just gives a little definition to the face. I think it's gonna be real cute. Thank you, Dana. All right. She's got that cute little nose. Is such a cute image. Has a lot of personality, right? All right, and I'm gonna go ahead and get her mouth while I'm doing all of this. I don't think I'm gonna do any shading from that. I'm just going to define it. But I do need to, you know what? I like how her face looks right now, so I'm going to hit it with my heat tool to dry it. So now it's nice and bone dry, and I can come in and add all those details. I'm gonna refer back to the stamp set. So the stamp set, she has some eyelashes and her eyebrows. So I'm just going to add those on. I'm gonna give this girl some eyelash extensions. Just kidding. She's cute. Okay. Alrighty, and take more of that vintage photo, and I'm just going to give her eyebrows. And because I'm a stickler about eyebrows, I'm going to give her just a little bit of a thicker brow. And as they say in all the beauty videos here on YouTube, eyebrows are not twins, they're sisters. Or if I'm lucky, they're cousins. Okay. Ooh, she's cute. Okay. Gonna add a little more shading right under her head on her neck. Okay, I like that. And just naturally, her arms got a little bit of shading, but Put a little more on. So cute. All right, I'm gonna hit this with my heat tool to dry it. And I'm just going to define the line of her nose, since that was on the stamp set. But I'm also going to give it just a little bit of shading down below. Probably should have thought about how I was shading the nose before I just went ahead and did it, so that it made sense. Okay. Shannon in the comments. That's too funny. She's like, my eyebrows, third cousins, twice removed on a good day. Too funny. I don't want any harsh edges on the nose, so I'm just softening everything. All right, and now let's work on her hair. I want her hair to be a slightly different tone of brown, so I am gonna bring in that ground espresso. But I think what I'm gonna do first is do like just a light layer of Vintage Photo, and then I'm going to come in and add detail with the ground espresso. So, just getting the color on here. We'll come back in a minute and add detail. Kind of love how sometimes distress inks sort of just have different colors that come out. I'm gonna sneeze. So sorry, guys. I'm waiting for someday when I stop getting my seasonal allergies. All right. Get this down under here too. Okay. We'll come back to that later. Okay, so my plan is that this blanket is going to be a red plaid because we're making this into a Christmas card, right? So we want like a red plaid, so her pajamas sort of have to go along with it, but not like maybe pink pajamas with a red heart. I think it'd be really cute. And then maybe it's like pink on her head wrap too. I like this idea. All right, let's do that. Okay. All right. I'm noticing something that I want to fix before I move on, though. This line right here. Okay. All right, so pink, and I'm thinking I might just use Festive Berries because that's like what I've got on my palette and I've kind of been already using it. So I'm going to, and I only need to like, you know, paint from there up. So I'm just getting a little bit of that Festive Berries, kind of spreading it around. I love that all of the girls in her stamp set are wearing pajamas. They're so cute. All right, I'm gonna dry this and then I can add more detail. Shading, dabbing off my brush. So I can bring in just a little bit of water. In fact, I might grab a little bit of purple to get this shading to the darkness where I want it, or maybe some aged mahogany would do it. Okay, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna grab a little aged mahogany. Just a deeper red. And hopefully, yeah, there we go. In fact, I can probably use that for the heart and the, like the neckline once I'm ready for it. See, this is why I did a whole bunch of prep work for this card, because we're spending all the time on painting. Okay. Hit that with my heat tool. And I'm gonna come in with that aged mahogany. And just to find the top line of her little nightgown. And then paint the little itty bitty heart. So cute. All right, I'm gonna work on her head wrap. So I'm gonna bring in, and this is where we can have more of that detail with the aged mahogany. So I'm gonna start spreading that festive berries around a little bit more. I really think all of the shadow and detail will come in from that aged mahogany color. You know how sometimes you're working on a project and you're not entirely sure how it's gonna go, and then you get going on it and you're like, oh yeah, this is gonna be a good one. I have a good feeling about this. Okay, so cute. All right, I'm gonna dry this so I can work on the shading on her head wrap. All right, coming into the aged mahogany to add the detail on top of this festive berries. I'm gonna have to get more aged mahogany. I'm adding too much water and I'm losing the intensity, so I've gotta smush some more on my palette. Here we go. There we go. Sorry, I'm concentrating. I'm trying to get all this shading There's a lot of little details on this head wrap. I didn't think it was so detailed, but it is. I love that. So cute. I'm gonna try to soften this edge that's kind of got a harsh edge forming. There we go. All right. Let's dry this and we'll move on to the detail on her hair. I'm not using super, super wet color, so I don't have to dry that for too long. Okay, so I'm going in with Ground Espresso. And I'm thinking, because I remember when I learned about coloring curly hair with Copics, it was all about just making like little swirls. Like put down a flat color and then start doing little swirls, and naturally you'll have some of that color underneath showing through. I'm just going around adding a little shading so it just starts to look like curly hair. Okay, just got a lot of curly hair up here, so let's see how this goes. Like you can like start to do a little swirling things, and then, oh sorry, my hand's gonna be in the way. Let's turn this so my hand's off to the side. Just like kind of like random swirly texture, and then you can go in and add more of like where the actual shading would be later. Helps that I'm using a paintbrush that has a really fine point on it. Probably should have done some research, gone over to Pocono Pam's YouTube channel and see how she colors curly hair like this. Because I'm sure she has some examples. Of course, she's mostly with Copics, but yeah. All right, bringing in a little bit of that darker color. Okay, so I basically have the curls sort of like defined. Now I'm going to come in, because there would just naturally be some darker areas like down right at the bottom of the head wrap. I think that's where there would be the most shading. So I can just start to bring that up. Sorry, hard to know where to put my hand. Okay, so I'm just spreading that up and into the curl area. I'm just trying to get a little bit of that color so there aren't so many bright spots. You know what I'm talking about? Like really bright spots. In fact, I'm gonna come in and kind of soften that one down here as well. I think if I mess with it any more than this, then all of her hair is going to lose that definition, so I think I better stop. But I like that. That looks really cute. Love. Okay. So now I need to work on her blanket, and I want it to have a red plaid. And I've already done a little bit for the greeting, which is this on this red cardstock. It's kind of a dark, I think this is cherry cardstock from Hero Arts. Or it might even be the cranberry. But so I need it to match this red on this greeting here. So I'm thinking that's maybe like a barn door color. That might not be quite right. No, it's about right. Barn door. All right. Except I'm going to do, because it's going to be a red plaid. All right, I have to think here. It's a base of red, then I'll add a little bit of a darker red on top. Maybe add a white line. Okay. I didn't think through last night when I was planning this exactly what it was going to be. So, all right, so I'm starting with that red shade, Barn Door. And I'm watering it down quite a bit because I need to have some space to darken things up with the plaid. So I'm just painting over this entire area. They're two different red tones right now, but I think that's okay. This is like more of a pinky, purpley red because I used Vested Berries. Okay. All right, and while that's drying, I'm gonna go ahead and do some shading on the pillow. And I think I will have the pillow be, I think I'm just gonna have it be white. So I'm going to take a little bit of pumice stone to do the shading. And I'll bring pumice stone in later when I work on the background. Okay. So I'm basically just adding pumice stone along the bottom of the pillow. I'm going to add some water to really fade that out from the edges. I don't think I'm going to do much more on the pillow because, you know, if I add any more color, it's not going to read like a really pale color anymore. Okay. That red up there isn't dry, so I'm going to hit it with my heat tool. On the plaid. So I think I'm gonna use that aged mahogany again, and that's gonna help tie the different red shades together. Fired brick's not a bad idea, but I think I'm gonna go aged mahogany so it kind of goes along with this one. Okay, and I need to follow the line of this, like the curve too. Okay. This is going to be difficult with this little tiny itty bitty brush. But but it is a little itty bitty blanket. So that's what I gotta do. Okay. Okay. Then I can finish off with this dark red on this other edge. Okay. I'm going to hit that with my heat tool once again because I need to paint the other direction. Go other direction. All right, I think I'm gonna want to follow this line right here. So I'm gonna start up there. Need more of my aged mahogany. It's amazing how much of the ink that you smush on your palette gets, you know, eaten up when you have to water it down so that it's more fluid. Okay. And then I'll finish off this last little line at the bottom. Okay. So cute. Okay, to really make it look like a plaid, it like takes it up a step. And those of you who have taken my Simply Watercolor Christmas class will know this, is if you use a slightly darker shade, so I'm going to take Ground Espresso and mix it with the aged mahogany so I get a little bit of a darker red, and this might be a bad idea, but I'm going to come in here and paint where these overlap. There we go, just like that. Okay. Because on actual plaid, that's what happens. Where the lines cross, there is a darkening of color. This is such a small little plaid area. It's taking a long time. But I think it will be worth it. I kind of like to think of this girl with the curly hair as Lydia. Although I think she might have her hair in braids now. But on the at the picture of her that's on the back of the stamp set, she has long curly hair. Oh, yay. That looks like a little plaid blankie. All right. And I think I'm going to hit that with my heat tool. Debating if I want to add white detail. I think I do. I'm grabbing my gouache. A thick white paint that you can water down. I don't need a whole lot of it because I'm only going to be adding little pinstripes to this, but I'm gonna get it going so it's pretty fluid. Sorry, here's my palette. Getting it so it's pretty fluid and easy to work with, and then I'm going to come in and add, oh sorry, I'm going to be probably blocking this because I got to, it's like precision work. Using the very tip to add that little itty bitty line. I just want a little bit of this detail. Okay, and then this direction. There we go. Oh, I love it so much. Okay. I'm thinking the pillow looks really out of place now because everything else is so detailed. No, don't mess with it. When I cut it out, there will be detail. Okay. So I'm going to hit this with my heat tool to dry it. Now you can see really how small it is compared to my hand. Like, that's tiny. I've never painted such a small pattern. Okay. And this is where the even more tedious part of the video comes into play. All right. So I am going to cut out her entire body, even though I only painted the, you know, the top, you know, 4/5 of it. I'm gonna check in the comments what we're saying here. Loving the plaid blanket. Add a plaid monogram to the pillow. That's not a bad idea, but I think most of her head will cover the pillow. Because I am planning to have it like she's on the pillow sleeping. Sorry, I'm concentrating on cutting so much. I can't even chat. Any questions in the chat? Dana, if you see any, will you grab them? And maybe paste them in or something? Sky Sarah saying, yay, fussy cutting is not so bad. Could be worse. Yeah, these images aren't too bad to cut out. I think the most detailed part is probably around her arms. The question for you guys in the chat, though, are you guys, you know, if you're American and celebrating Thanksgiving, are you putting up Thanksgiving decorations, getting all into that, or are you going straight to Christmas? Because I know so many people this year are just going straight to Christmas. They're like, we need some Christmas cheer. All right, I don't know how I'm going to get her little arm up there. I guess just like this. There we go. Not too bad. And then I can just, I don't need to worry about the detail down here since the blanket will cover it, right? All right, so now let's cut out the pillow and the blanket. And then we can just put her to bed for a Christmas Eve nap. Thank you for answering questions, Dana. I just saw that you answered someone's question. Everyone go check out Dana's channel. She has a holiday card series on her channel. I think she just finished it up. I could be wrong. Okay, so there's the cute little pillow. And now the blanket. Okay. Brandy has a question. When you're die cutting, how do you prevent creases from the cutting mats? I have dies where I like using the negative as well, but it tends to get ruined because of the creases. It's a really good question. When I have a paper that's just showing creases like that, sometimes I will put a really thin piece of paper in between the cutting pad and my cardstock that I'm cutting. And I do that for a lot of different instances. I do that for when I want to prevent that crease. I do it when I've painted something and I'm not really sure if the paint's going to transfer to my cutting plate. Sometimes I do that. Those are mostly the only times I do it. Like when I want to protect what I'm cutting, that's when I will put just like a really thin piece of paper in between, just like computer paper, really thin, really thin. Okay. Started with Thanksgiving decorations, but put up my tree first week of September. Wow. Nancy is really speeding through the year. She's like, I want 2020 to be over. Started with Thanksgiving decorations, but put up my tree the first week of September and took the Thanksgiving down. Now I only have Christmas up. That is some hardcore Christmas. Well, you know what? Some people who say Christmas doesn't start till Thanksgiving has passed, or even more extreme, December 1st. I think, how sad is that? You only get to celebrate, you know, be in the Christmas cheer for 25 days, you know, or maybe a little longer if it's right after Thanksgiving. For me, really, I was explaining this to my fiance. I was like, for me, when it comes to Christmas, it comes in three waves. There's the first wave, which comes in June, because that's when I'm designing product for a Simisa stamp. We start designing for Stamptember in June, and we always include some holiday-related items in that release. So I break out the Christmas music, and I start you know, get in the Christmas mood. And then there's a pause. Probably until around end of September, which is when I start thinking about my holiday card series. So then now I have another wave of like Christmas music and going through Christmas stuff. And then by the time by about December 1st comes around, I'm sort of like losing that, you know, or maybe as the holiday card series winds down. And then right before Christmas, there's a third wave. So I get to celebrate Christmas three times. Okay, so how cute is this going to be? Oh my word. Stop it. Stop it. I don't even want to put her on a card. I just want to hold her here. And then like have a little blank, have the little pillow. She's so cute. Oh my word. I love that so much. Okay, before I do anything else, the white edge on her hair is kind of bugging me. So I'm going to take my paintbrush and just paint that white edge so that it doesn't show. Just around that really, really dark area. And I didn't get it like all the way, but just, you know, just enough to hide that. Okay. Oh my word. I just need these images a little bigger to make like paper dolls for my nieces. They'd love it. Okay. So the plan for the card, because now it's all about the assembly. Well, actually, we have one more thing to do before we start assembling, and I got to stand up for all this. First of all, I'm going to get rid of my palette. I'm just going to push it off to the side, out of the way. And this is going to be a slimline card. I prepped my card base. I'll zoom out even more. I prepped my card base. Ta-da. And this is a slightly larger slimline. I made it 3 3/4 wide by 9 1/4 tall. And that's because I have this long number 10 envelope from Simus the Stamp. And this fits just perfectly. Takes up all the advantage of the space. All right, so I'm going to save this card base. And we're going to work on the pattern that's going to go behind her and all the stuff. So I have this stencil from Simus the Stamp called Scattered Stars. This just came out today as well. And I'm going to do some ink blending. So I'm getting out my Easy Clean Matte from Tonic. And I'm going to blend this in a really neutral color so that it doesn't clash with any of the red we've got going. So, starting with a clean blender brush, because I realized I had never used a blender brush with the color Pumice Stone. And the way I differentiate between oxide brushes, because you don't want to use a blender brush that you've used oxide inks on. You don't want to use that with your Distress regular dye inks. So the way I've differentiated it is, can you see that? There's a little bit of red nail polish just around the neck. So I know this one is designated for oxides. So, and you know what? This is looking a little bit dark. I had to do this last week on camera too. Hold on. I'm gonna change the exposure. There we go. There we go. Now we're nice and bright. Probably needed a little bit darker when I was up close on the painting, but now we're good. Okay, I'm going to do a layer of Pumice Stone, and I want it to be a pretty intense color at the top, and it's going to fade down. So we're starting on one end. In fact, we might have to mix up a few different colors because this is really pale. I didn't realize how soft it was going to be. Not a huge deal. We'll just see if I need to. All right, this cardstock is Nina Classic Crest Solar White, and it is cut to the same size as my card front. I don't think I'll end up trimming it down, but that is the size. And just as a reminder, the size is 9 1/4 tall by 3 3/4 wide. Alrighty. Oh, I keep bending the paper. Stop it. This is when I need to have like Christmas music playing in the background, right? Would you guys want that for these lives? I could like put together a playlist and just have it softly playing in the background. I think sometimes it can be distracting, so I don't know. Okay. I think that's about where I'm gonna go because I only want to come down as far as my star stencil. So there we go, that's not bad. Alrighty, speaking of the star stencil, I'm gonna put that right over the top, turn over my paper, and I'm going to use a little bit of washi tape just to tape it to the paper so that I can go all the way off the edge and I don't have to worry about the edge. Okay. All right, so this is when I'm gonna be bringing in like full strength color because I want the stars to show up, right? In fact, let's peek underneath and just make sure that's happening. Oh yeah, that's working, okay. I want them to kind of fade as they come near the bottom. So I'm not adding quite as much ink right down here. I'm gonna lift this up just to see. Okay, that's pretty cute. Okay. Let's see how that fared. Not bad. Just a little bit of texture on it. I don't have a really even color, but that's okay. I don't think I really want a super even color today. I just wanted probably just that, yeah. So, I'm gonna clean this down with my baby wipe. I'll probably have to take that to a sink and really rinse that later, but I used Distress Oxide ink, so it should come off really easy in the sink. In fact, protect the painting. Okay. Oh yeah, that was a good choice for the background. Now that I'm looking at the background along with the girl that I painted, oh yeah. And save these little bits of washi tape for later. Oh no, that one's got ink on it. Never mind. Okay. So here's where we get into the greeting. Now I'm trying to make this Christmassy, right? So I'm going to have her down here on her little pillow, taking a little Christmas nap, right? That's where she's going to be. So I've done some prep work. I cut out a bunch of letters. And I used this die set from Concord and Knight. This is all the letters, lots of skinny letters. I thought the greeting for this could be Sweet Christmas Dreams. I know, it's so corny and sweet, but you know what? It's gonna be adorable. Okay, so what I did was I cut out all the letters and I arranged them and then took Glad Press and Sale. Like after I have them like arranged, I can put it just like that. I'm gonna put glue on the back and then I can get them positioned just right. When I can pick them up like this, it just makes everything easier. All right, so then I can adhere that one right there. And then I have my Christmas that I cut out earlier, and that's gonna go right there. Sweet Christmas dreams. Right? So cute. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna move her off until I have everything adhered. I'm gonna keep these where they're at too, but I can zoom in so you can see better what I'm doing. Okay. I'm gonna be using some Gina K Connect Glue today. And the idea is because I put Glad Press and Seal, like holding these letters in place, like I put the letters down and then I put the press and seal on and picked everything up all at once. So now I can add glue to them all at once. Just adding little dots of glue. Plus, then it gives you handles for holding. Okay. So this is coming underneath. All right. I'm just gonna let that sit there. That's gonna go right there. I'm gonna put glue on the back of this one. Sorry, now it's a little bright when I zoom in. Let's do this. There, now you can see a little better what I'm doing. It's not as bright, but you can see the background now. I will adjust the exposure later as well. All right, and this one was just like right below, like about right here. Press that down. Dana says, press and seal is a staple in my craft room. Yes, girl, that is so true. I don't use it super often, but it is invaluable when I do. Like this is when, you know, like this is when you need it. Okay, so I'm gonna very carefully peel this up. And since that's glued down, it's going to hold. Oh, lovely. Sweet. Right? Okay, I just put this one down, so I might have to be a little more careful as I peel. But okay. Looks like I missed a little bit of glue right under this letter A. I will show you how I add glue to that. So I'm going to put glue on the end of this little piece, and then I lift the A, or just like slide this under, add a little glue underneath, and I can press that down. All right. Now for the, I can grab my tweezers. Okay, and now I'm gonna kick up that exposure just a little bit. Okay, much better. Zoom out, and now I can put her at the bottom. Oh, she's so cute. All right, I need to figure out where I'm going to have the pillow. I guess I could have the pillow be off to the side, but I think I want it just behind her head. Like she's just taking a little nap, right? Just like that. There we go. All right, so this is going to be flush with the card, so I'm going to put adhesive on the back. And then come in and put that right there. Then I need to put foam adhesive on the back of her. All right, so I'm going to do big thing of foam tape there. Where'd my scissors go? I'm just gonna cut this in half. Put that right there. All right, just getting, where is this going? All right, and then I need to put just a little bit of foam adhesive on the bottom of the blank. Oh, hello, it just flipped off. All right, foam adhesive, you don't want to be there. That's okay. Put that right down there. And I'm going to put a little bit of glue just right there, because that's what's going to be pressed up against her midsection. So cute. Okay. I'm thinking this needs, some of you old school ones will know exactly what this needs. This needs a dashed line, right? Because I've got quite a bit of space around the outer edge. I think a dashed line would really set this off. So I'm going to grab, let's see, that'll work, 0.3 Copic Multiliner. But you know what, maybe I'll adhere this to the card first and then do this. So put my Tombow Extreme adhesive right on the edge of my card base. And I like to do just a couple little strips right down the middle. And then put this directly on top. Perfect. All right. Now I'm going to go around, and I'm not going to use a ruler because I don't want to make this like super precise. I just want like a little stitch line. In fact, I'm going to have it wobble a little bit, almost so it looks like the stitching on a blanket. Like purposely making it wobble. This is a really tall card. It's hard to get it all in frame. But here we go. Sweet Christmas dreams. You can see her. She's so cute. She's just having a sweet little Christmas dream. All right. And I think I just want to like zoom in on her because she's like the star of the show, right? Adorable. I'm so excited. She looks so cute. I was nervous because I was like, how was this going to translate to a Christmas card? But I really wanted to use it today. I'm glad it worked out. Anyway, do you guys have any questions before I close up the live? This is day six. Just a reminder that if you want to see any other day six video from the holiday card series from years past, I have those listed down below in the video description. So you can just like click over and have a little walk down memory lane. Okay. Any other questions or comments? I haven't had lunch yet, so I'm very looking forward to going downstairs, having some lunch. Thank you. I'm so glad all of you like it. I was concerned it wasn't going to turn out. I'm so glad. Sometimes like watercoloring people figures can be hard. Dana, I want to pet her. Okay. All right. Well, I'm going to close up today's video. Thank you so much for joining me today. And thank you. Oh wait, I have a question. Have you ever faced any embossing powder issues where the powder behaves like glitter powder and sticks all over, even though you use an anti-static powder tool? Yes, usually that means the embossing powder is old. That's in my experience, that's what it's been. I don't know. Sometimes an anti-static powder tool might not be enough. You could get like a dryer sheet or even like, back in the day, what I would do, I got that like Scotchgard spray, like for staticing on your clothing, and you can like spray your cardstock and just like spray in the air and then just kind of fan your paper in it. And that just adds a little bit of that to the surface of the paper. Might help. I don't know. That's a hard one. All right. Thank you all so much for joining me. I will see you guys on Monday. Maybe sooner than that. I need to film the mail call video for October. So you might see that coming up the next few days if I have time to film that. So thank you so much for joining me. I will see you guys, like I said before, on Monday for sure for day 7 of the holiday card series. Thanks for joining me.